You're watching Tea Time, Conscious Conversation and Organic Tea. Today, I'm drinking some amazing homemade chai tea. This is an amazing blend for the colder seasons of the year, or you can have it in the warmer seasons if you have it iced. It's nice like that too. But now we're just entering November and it's a little bit chilly outside, and I really love a good cup of chai tea. And of course, organic is important. Today I'm going to talk about how the importance of organic food can raise your frequency. Organic food and other input of our environment raises our frequency, as does non-organic food lower our frequency sometimes. Depending on how high our frequency is and the input that we're giving our body and our senses, also depicts the abilities that we have in this world. Now, when I'm talking about the abilities, I'm talking about our physical abilities, our mental abilities, our emotional capacity, and even our spiritual abilities or extra sixth senses, things like that. So how does it affect our physical body? Our physical body is affected by what we eat simply because we are what we eat. Like the old cliche says, what we put into our body is what we become. We become the food that we are eating. We eat food and it goes into our body, and we take out the nutrients and we take and remove the waste, and the rest of it becomes who we are. We are what we eat. Therefore, when we put things of high frequency, high energy, life-living food into our body, we in turn are raising our frequency. When we put foods that are of low frequency into our body, things that are super processed, low density foods without nutrition, we are actually hindering the health of our body, because the cell nutrient turnover, cells turnover doesn't have the nutrients in order to create healthy cells, and often that's what cancer comes from, and other ailments as well. And when we do have ailments, we can actually use things like food or herbs and other natural medicines in order to raise the frequency of our body back up to that of a healthy frequency and a health of a healthy human body. Our electromagnetic fields are very important and are conductive, and what we put into our body also has an effect on how our electromagnetic field is functioning. And the more high frequency things that we put into our body, the more conductive our electromagnetic field is, and the healthier we stay. Now, our emotional and mental bodies can also be affected by the things that we eat and by organic food and organic medicines as well. And so when we feel like our emotions may be out of whack, it may be because our diet and the foods that we are intaking may not be providing proper nutrients, may not be providing the essential things that we need in order to have a balanced emotional system, as well as our mental system. When we feel lethargic, when we feel like we just can't function properly, our brains aren't remembering, our brains aren't acting the same way and have the same cognitive abilities that we do on a day-to-day basis, and all of a sudden these cognitive abilities seem hindered, it could be because of the nutrition. It could be because of the frequency of the foods, and in turn, if they are organic, or if they're super processed, or even if they have poisons, pesticides, genetically modified, and so on. So the more clear foods we eat, the more clear we think and feel. And there's also certain herbs that help with our brain function, including rosemary. Rosemary essential oil is proven to be a memory stimulant. It helps with brain function, and it helps with many other parts of our health system and rebalancing. And so, just for an example, if one essential oil has the ability to affect our brain state, then imagine all of the other plants and medicines that are doing that as well, and in turn the food that we're intaking. So I'm just going to give you a brief summary today about my experience and eating organic. I used to, when I was young, I basically all the food was organic, and then as I started to grow older, it became that most all the food became conventionally grown with pesticides and chemicals and chemical nutrients and things like that. And I became sensitive to a bunch of foods that I was used to eating, and I didn't understand why until I saw an interview with Robin O'Brien, and I was like, wow, that exactly resonates with what I'm going through. And I really highly recommend watching some of her TED Talks and some of her information about the power of food and the power of eating organic and what genetically modified foods have done to the human health system, and especially in America. Many of these foods that are super processed and have no nutritional content have actually been banned in many countries, and America is one of the last to continue to put these foods on our shelf, put these poisons on our shelf and market them as food. One thing that I noticed as I had children is that the foods that we were eating were directly impacting our health and the experience of life that we were having and the quality of life that we were experiencing. The foods that we were getting from the grocery stores, often not fully organic or certified, and often were genetically modified. I didn't really have the mental awareness and the education that I do now about all these foods and what they're doing to our bodies. So I didn't know I was poisoning my children and myself until we started to change our diet, and we started to change the things that we ate in and started to eat whole, healthy foods. We started to not eat processed foods like boxed dinners. We started to eat many fruits and vegetables. We eliminated a lot of dairy and wheat out of our diet and started eating ancient grains and other substitutes for milk, like rice milk. And our health dramatically improved. It is incredible. And I really would suggest anyone try it for themselves. Go a month without eating processed foods. Eat, you know, plant-based diet. Eat a little bit of healthy meats and healthy dairy that are, you know, uncontaminated and from really high quality, high frequency sources. And you'll notice a difference in how your body functions, how your brain functions, how your emotions are balanced, and how your spirit is also lifted. And that sends me into the last part of my discussion for the day. And that is how what we eat directly contributes to our spiritual abilities. And when we consume and we consume and we consume and we are not conscious on what we're eating, and we're eating a bunch of junk, that is lowering our frequency and our spiritual abilities to the point where we are stuck in survival mode. We aren't really even concerned about what else is there. What is there more to life? Asking greater questions, and in turn also gaining abilities that the mundane life doesn't necessarily support. So the more superfoods that we eat, the more high frequency herbs, the ability of the brain and ability of telecommunication, telepathy, all sorts of abilities that are often considered sixth senses are increased and exponentially our abilities are fortified. So have you ever thought about one of those times where you are thinking something and then all of a sudden somebody says it? Well, that is because we're all psychic, essentially. It's just a matter of how we acknowledge that and how we are treating our antennas. And so the more open our antennas are and the more clear and clean they are, the more they're able to perceive and receive and put out input and also receive input. And so when we are in a place of lower frequency, a lot of those internal systems get shut down. And when we live in fear, and often when we consume things that aren't organic or aren't harvested in a humane way, often that increases our fear, which lowers our frequency. And when we live in fear, we are living from a place where we are disempowered. And when we release the fear and realize love, and we realize interconnection and how everything is a lesson, then like a little bud, we bloom and our energy field is more open, and we are able to conduct ourselves in a higher manner, in a way that our abilities are more clear and our functions are at full capacity. Our DNA is activated. It's really an amazing correlation that I found in my life, and I really wanted to share it with you. So I hope you enjoyed this video today. If you do and you would like to see more, make sure you push the like button, and you can also subscribe to Wildcraft Wellness. I hope you enjoyed this, and I look forward to sharing more videos of tea time with you. Conscious conversation and organic tea.